You're watching the free version of Silhouette Essentials. For projects and footage, head to borisfx.com for the premium download.
Now it's time to work on the foreground leg. I've sped things up and I've already done my track. I tracked with a Mocha tracker with translation, scale, and rotation. And I think we got a pretty good track. But this time I want to try to make my shape for the leg all in one piece because I feel like the leg moves pretty fluidly. There's not a lot of change and it might speed up the process. So I've already made my shape here, which is the blue shape, and I'll turn off my tracking shape. And then I'll also put the stabilized view onto the foreground leg. And now we can see it's stabilized in the viewer. So when I look at this, I see this final position and then I see the end position, and I'm going to try to use some different editing tools here. So I'm going to click on the reshape tool here, which is R, and I'm going to switch to the magnetic reshape tool. I'm going to select points here. So what I'm going to change here is that this kind of anchored up here in the hip area. And I'm just going to try to change this lower leg area. So I'm going to select all the points. And I usually use the rectangle selection tool, but you can also use the lasso tool. And you can hold down the control command key, and you can just select the points that you need. So how that is set up is that you can either have the lasso or you can have the rectangular selection set up in the preferences. And if you want to use the opposite one at any time, you just hold down control command and you'll get the opposite tool that's not set in the preferences. Okay, so let's move this shape here with these points. So it's kind of like a magnet. So I'm sort of like pulling things into place, and it worked a little bit. Then I can just keep selecting more points here and move things closer to the leg, move the control points. However, it can only get me so far, and I'm going to switch to the brush reshape, and I'm going to click R again, and now you can see it has the circular icon. I'm in the brush reshape, and now I can just move groups of points that are within the radius of the brush tool. Sometimes I use a really large radius, and sometimes I make it really small just to select actual points. So this is really nice when you have areas where it's not tons of detail and you just can grab a large group at once. Let's go to the middle of the shot and see if we need a keyframe there. Alt X. And that looks pretty good. And then we'll go in between again. Alt X. And then again. And then we'll just go backwards. Alt-Z. And if we need to make our brush radius smaller, you just hold down the command key, control command, and make it smaller. And Alt-Z again to go in between. Okay, so I think that shape is done, and that was really quick. I'll turn off the stabilization in the viewer to none, and we'll just scrub through and take a look. Okay, now we can start on the background leg. Next up here, we're going to do this background leg. So if I scrub through my timeline, I'm going to look for a frame where I can try to do some tracking. It looks like I'm probably going to have to split the leg into two shapes. It looks like this shin area below the knee gets occluded by the foreground leg, and so tracking probably really won't help with that, but we can track the upper leg. So I'm going to make a shape here, just around the outside, to see if we can just capture this movement. And we'll track with the Mocha tracker, Shift T, to open the tracking tab with translation, scale, and rotation. And we'll track to the beginning of the shot. Okay, we can see here towards the beginning of the shot that the tracking sort of breaks. We lose sight of this background leg and it starts following the foreground leg. So we'll just go into the timeline here and delete those bad keyframes that won't work for us. Probably from about here to the end, I'm going to select them in the timeline and click delete with my cursor inside the timeline. And now we don't have those keyframes anymore. Okay, we'll go back to where we can see our object clear in frame. I'm going to name my layer because I think my track looks good. BG leg upper. I'm going to make my tracker shape green and turn it off. We'll go up to the stabilize icon here and we will stabilize this layer in the viewer, BG leg upper. And now we'll make our shape. I'm going to zoom in a little bit here. And I'm not going to include the pocket because the pocket changes a little bit when the leg rotates. So the movement is different from the leg. All right, let's take a look. Okay, that's pretty locked on. Just a few areas to edit.